Hello everybody, this is Digital Blackboard by Sachin P. Nagmote. In this video, we are going to discuss the topic, what is UPS and how it works. So watch this video till the end, you will get better understanding about what is UPS and exactly how it works. So basically UPS is nothing but uninterrupted power supply. So we are talking about a power supply which can never be interrupted. So why there is a need of UPS? So we are having many applications which require continuous power supply. For example, intensive care unit. So in ICU, there are many equipments connected which require continuous supply. Otherwise, the life of the patient will be in threat. So we need to ensure the continuous power supply to all the equipments in ICU. Similarly, if we are working on our personal computer and if the computer gets switched off, then there is always a threat to lose the data. And that's why continuous supply has to be there for the personal computer. So to ensure this continuous power supply, we have to make an arrangement. And this arrangement is called as uninterrupted power supply. So it is important to ensure continuous supply for many applications, and for that we require UPS. Now how exactly the UPS work? So this is the block diagram of UPS. So from where we are getting the main supply. So we are getting the main supply from the board. So single phase or three phase AC supply is available from the mains. So this main supply is given to the load. So when we connect the main supply to the load, we have to insert one switch, and that switch is called as main static switch. And this main static switch is normally on, in on condition. So here we can see the load is receiving the supply from the main line. And that's why our load is on. So for example, if we take television, so our television is on now because the television is receiving the supply from the main switch. But if for any reason the main supply is not available, then what can happen? So if the main supply is not available, then our load can get switched off because load is not receiving the supply. So this should not happen, and that's why we have to make an arrangement. So how this arrangement has to be done? So we have to use one rectifier, then inverter, and then we have to use one switch and then battery. Now see, we have connected rectifier, then inverter, then one switch which is called as UPS switch, and one battery. So when the main supply is available, so see what exactly happening. So here the UPS static switch, it is in normally off, and main static switch is normally on because the chances of having main supply available is more, and that's why the main static switch is normally on and the UPS static switch is normally off. So when the main supply is available, so load is receiving the supply from the main line, and at the same time our battery is getting charged. But as battery required DC, so we are using rectifier. So rectifier converts the AC supply into DC and it charges the battery. So when the main supply is available, the battery is getting charged. Okay, now if in any, because of any reason, the main supply is not available, see what is exactly happening here. So the main static switch is getting open and the UPS static switch is getting closed. See, the moment main supply is not available, the UPS static switch is getting closed and the main static switch is getting open. And load is still receiving the power. Load is still receiving the supply through inverter. Now here, battery is giving us DC and inverter converts that DC into AC. And hence, the load is getting continuous supply. Even the main supply is not available. So, when the main supply is not available, load is receiving the supply from battery. And as battery is DC, so we have to connect one inverter. Inverter convert that DC into AC. So in both the conditions, whether the main supply is available or if the main supply is not available, load continuously receives the power and load is on. So this arrangement is called as UPS, and the whole arrangement is called as uninterrupted power supply. So whether the supplies, main supply is available or not available, we are having continuous supply to the load. So this is an arrangement for uninterrupted power supply. So I hope you got better understanding about UPS. So please like, share and subscribe Digital Blackboard. And for any query, you can contact Sachin Nagmati.